Singapore, the last round of the Program for International Student Assessment, PISA, study measured 500,000 students from more than 70 economies on their strengths in mathematics, science, and reading. For the first time, the triennial test conducted by the Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, OECD, also included an assessment on an important 21st century driver, collaborative problem-solving skills, which students from 52 economies, including Singapore, participated in. It was part of the move in recent years by the OECD to broaden the test to measure social and emotional skills that are becoming increasingly crucial to thrive in the new economy. On Tuesday afternoon, November 21, Singapore was named the top-performing economy in collaborative problem-solving, with its students performing significantly above those from all other education systems. The next round of tests, PISA 2018, will include a test on global competence which would look at how well students can navigate an increasingly diverse world, with an awareness of different cultures and beliefs. In 2021, PISA is looking at assessing creative thinking. The organization headquartered in Paris has defined global competence as the capacity to examine global and intercultural issues, to take multiple perspectives, to engage in open, appropriate, and effective interactions with people from different cultures, and to act for collective well-being and sustainable development. So how exactly will students be assessed on this? In the first part, students will read about a case study, and respond to questions that evaluate their capacity to understand the complexity of the case, the multiple perspectives of the diverse actors involved, and suggest solutions. This will be followed by a questionnaire to gauge their openness towards people from other cultures, respect for cultural otherness, global-mindedness, and responsibility. Teachers and school heads will also be given a questionnaire which aims to provide a comparative picture of how education systems are integrating global, international, and intercultural perspectives through the curriculum and other activities. OECD, in its proposal to include this measure of global competence, has said it is the first step towards assessing what students are learning about the complexity of a globalizing and multicultural world, and to what extent they are prepared to address global developments and collaborate productively across cultural differences. It also hopes that the data will provide worldwide, comparative information on what schools and teachers are doing to prepare young people for global citizenship and hopefully surface best practices. Dr. Andreas Schleicher, OECD's Director for Education and Skills, said it was important to measure students' capacity to work with others, because in today's increasingly interconnected world, people are often required to collaborate in order to achieve their goals. He was in Singapore on Tuesday afternoon to reveal the results of the PISA study on collaborative problem solving. In an earlier interview with The Straits Times on PISA's move to test global competence, he said it was important to nurture the capacity of students to look at the world through different lenses and perspectives, appreciate different ways of thinking and different cultures.